us blind, but now I see.
Praising our Savior all the day long. I don't know if y'all can hear me or not. Okay, good, good, good. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Forest Heights Baptist Church worship service. Welcome to those here in the sanctuary, those who are on Zoom, those who are on YouTube, and those listening on the phone. We welcome you in the name of Jesus. We pray that this service will give you a blessing, and that you will share the message that you will hear today with others. Amen. Let's see. I got another bunch of announcements. So, like I said last Sunday, if you're listening, say amen.
Amen. Amen.
All right, all right. WMU will meet Tuesday at 7 p.m. on Zoom. Church council meeting after service today. After service today. The baby shower for Anna is this coming Saturday at 2 p.m. in the fellowship hall. Envelopes for the Easter egg hunt and for the Yoke Fellow Baptist Men's Ministry should be in your bulletins. If not, you got your bulletins early and they're on the table if there's some left. We need to make sure that we have enough for the Easter egg hunt. For to feed them and have the eggs, which they're looking for the eggs. We're trying to find these golden eggs. Last year, the golden eggs had money in them. So we're trying to find some golden eggs. So, and in order to keep movie night going and other things going for that the Men's Fellowship is doing, we need some donations for that. Well, they incurred a expense that they didn't know that they would have. So we need to stand up and fill in the gap for that. Those who are going right now media for the Bible study, the email has already been sent out for this week's lesson number 4. It's on intercessor. Please go on now and look for your email. If you don't have your email, you have plenty of time to call the church and tell them that you don't have your email or link on it. Listen to it. It's only about 10 or 12 minutes. Write down the scriptures that we will be discussing, and we'll be ready for Bible study on Wednesday. We have to get in the habit of looking at the video before so we can just discuss what we saw on Wednesday. This coming Sunday, next Sunday, fourth Sunday will be Youth Sunday. Youth Sunday.
Amen.
So the youth will be doing a little this and a little that. The only thing they probably won't be doing is preaching. We're going to leave that to Reverend Jones. But one day, who knows? Who knows? My son sat in these pews when he was a youth, and he's in the studying to be a minister now himself. So you never know. You never know. Let's see here. I think that's all the announcements that we have for this week. Everybody have a safe and blessed week. Oh, I'm sorry. One more, y'all. Listen up, listen up. VBS meeting was supposed to have been this Sunday, but because of the church council meeting, it's going to be next Sunday. But those who are planning on participating in VBS, you can still let Gloria Murray know. Next week, you will have the background investigations that will need to be filled out. Okay? So that's it. The floor is yours, Clarence.
And again, welcome to those who are watching via Zoom, YouTube, listening on the phone, and of course, those who are in the sanctuary with us right now. How joyful are you? All right. Did you know that there are different types of joy? So we're going to talk about two of them, the satisfying joy and lasting joy. our scripture, I'll let you locate that. It's 1 Peter. It's chapter 1, it's verse 8. And we're talking about satisfying joy. And then the second one is lasting joy, and that's John 16:22. So just a little introduction. Satisfying joy. Unlike happiness, joy is true satisfaction. Several times, God's word describes joy as full or complete. Joy satisfies the heart in a way that temporary happiness never can. So in 1 Peter, it's just 1 Peter chapter 1, it's just verse 8. It says, though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not know, now see him, you believe in him and rejoice with joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory. And then lasting joy. When we think of something lasting, what is it? That means, is that here for a minute, gone the next minute, or here for a second, gone the next second, or is that something that stays with us? So lasting joy says sorrow and suffering will pass, but joy continues in spite of hardship. Eternal joy is promised to come, and when it does, it lasts. So that's John 16 in the scripture for John 16:22. It says, so also you have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you. So that's lasting joy. Let us pray. Father, we just thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father, that you woke us up this morning, Lord. You watched over us as we slept last night, Father. And we just thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord, that we are here at this time, Father. Lord, we can be joyful, Father, that we know that you are with us. Your grace and your mercy is with us, and it lasts forever, Lord. And we just thank you, Father. Lord, we just give you all the praise, Lord. We give you the honor, and we give you the glory. And again, Father, we just thank you, Father. We pray, Lord, for those who are not with us at this time, Lord, praying that you're keeping them in your hands and keeping your arms of protection around them, Father. And Lord, we just thank you, Father. We thank you for your gift of salvation. And Lord, we thank you, Father, for the joy that you give us, Lord, even in our times of despair. We pray these things in the name of your Son, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good morning, Forest Heights. If you would, please stand to your feet and join us in our opening hymn found on page 22. Well, hymn number 22, Bless the Lord, Bless His Holy Name. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. He has done great things. 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 Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. He died for my sin. 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 bless his holy name. Oh, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Amen. As we prepare for our offering and get ready to receive our offertory prayer, we will begin singing, "You Can't Beat God Giving, No Matter How Hard You Try." You can't beat, you can't beat God giving, no matter how you try. And just as sure as you are living and the Lord is in heaven on high, the more you give, the more he gives to you. Just keep on giving, because it's really true that you can't beat God giving, no matter how you try.
Good morning. Let us remain standing for the offertory prayer. Most good and gracious Heavenly Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Prince of Peace, Father, we thank you. We thank you for loving us and blessing us. We thank you for providing for us and protecting us. Father, for comforting us when we're sad, for giving us that little boost when we doubt our own abilities. Father, you have given us everything we have, and right now we're giving back to you what is yours. We do so cheerfully. We pray that these offerings and gifts will be used as you see fit to further your kingdom. In your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. And Lord, haste the day when the faith shall be sight, the clouds be rolled back as a scroll, the trump shall resound, and the Lord shall descend. Even so, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. It is well. Is with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. Oh, it is well with my soul. With my soul. Oh, it is well. It is well with my soul. One last time, it is well. It is well.
It is well.
With my soul.
With my soul.
It is well. It is well with my soul.
Yes. Is it well? Is it well? That's something that we can all look at and have a self-examination and say, is it well? If it is well, you'll have peace. That surpasses all understanding. It is well. It is well with my soul. We praise God this morning You praise God from whom all blessings flow. I thank God for our pastor, this man of compassion. You know, there was once a pastor up north that shared with me some years ago. He said, before people care about what you know, they want to know. Could you say that again? They want to know that you care. So I thank God for this compassionate brother that sits on my right side, for his spirit and for his vision. Charlotte Hall, I didn't see you last week, did I? I missed you last week. Well, you weren't here. You can't be staying away from us. You got to be here. We miss you. What a wonderful, bless your heart, what a wonderful spirit you have. What a wonderful spirit. We love you, Charlotte. Know that we love you. You are well loved. Thank God for these men here, Forest Heights. Praise be to God for the work that they have been doing. I'm extremely excited. We had the opportunity to on a Wednesday, I believe, but we ran cable from the back of the church to the fellowship hall. Now, what this cable will do is enhance our capability of showing movies. It will enhance our capability of not only that, but anything on the internet. And so I thank God we had a meeting on last Sunday, and certainly God had put it all together. But we thank the men for their steadfast and always looking to enhance the opportunity. I had Sister Gloria Murray, our new directress, VBS directress. That's my classmate, my new member's classmate. We had the opportunity, but she's always with the in terms of the movie. She brings a family here, and it's always good to see you and the family that comes. We look forward to that family. Thank you for all that you do. Now, I see that some people may have forgotten about their clocks. I'm looking, and I see that some people may have forgotten about it, but that's okay. They that are here, we're thankful for you. I had to set mine ahead early yesterday afternoon. But we are, again, 1 hour ahead. We are 1 hour ahead. We're praying for the Lynch family this morning and also the Jones family. We'll be funeralizing them this week. Tell your loved ones that you love them. Tell them that you love them. You never know. These unexpected transitionings, and I don't say they die, but they transition from this world to the next. But, you know, having that opportunity or the ability to share with them while they're in close proximity, in close proximity. We are looking in the book of Ezekiel today, in the book of Ezekiel today. We are in the 37th chapter in the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 37. I hear some pages still turning, so that's why I'm just patiently waiting. Ezekiel chapter 37, we're starting at verse 1, Ezekiel 37. Allow me to pray prior to reading the word of God, the Holy Writ. Eternal and all-wise God, I stand before you today, God. Father, I ask that you remove anything that is of me, that you examine me. I ask for your forgiveness for the sins that either knowing or unknowing that have been committed. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you continue to discipline me, to guide me, and I'm praying for they that are in the sound of my voice, that you continue to bless them. Bless them, Father, in such a way so that they may be a blessing unto others. Remove me, Father. Let it hear all of thee. It is in Jesus' name. He who said, if he be lifted up, he will draw all men unto he. It is in that name that I pray and say, amen, amen, amen. Chapter 37, can we read for the reading of God's word? Chapter 37, starting at verse 1. 37, starting at verse 1, the word of God. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. And again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God unto the bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am Lord. So I prophesied, and I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking. And the bones came together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came upon them, and the skin covered them above. But there was no breath in them. And then said unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man. And say to the wind, thus saith the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. So I prophesied, and he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. Verse 11, then he said unto me, son of man, these bones are of the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, our bones are dried, and our hope is lost. We are cut off for our parts. Please be seated. The word of God for the people of God. A computer can be programmed. What we put into that computer will determine what will come out of that computer. We have what is called the input, the output, but it's the process that it goes through. An animal, it can be trained. It can be conditioned with rewards. You give it a bone. Its tail wags. You punish it, it will back down. You can teach it to obey. People, I heard somebody laugh. What? People have a different scenario. People have what they call and what God has allowed is a free will. They can choose one way or the other. People have a mindset of their own. We as God's children must learn to obey our Father, he who created in the image of himself. We must learn to obedient. Ezekiel had a choice. Ezekiel, we're in the book of Ezekiel, the 37th chapter. Ezekiel chose by choice. He had free will. He could have done what he wanted to do. He chose to obey God. One of the things that when I look at scripture, I look at the application, how it applies to me. How does this scripture apply to me? I have a choice. I can be disobedient or I can be obedient. It's up to me. I've got a free will. I can do this or I can do that. We as God's children, but understanding that there are consequences, there are consequences to doing what you want to do. Now, one of the things I also realized when I was a kid, if I did what I wanted to do, there were consequences. Was I able to deal, as a kid, with the consequences? I quickly learned that I didn't want to. Ezekiel chose to do the will of God. Are we choosing that same choice? Can these bones be revived? Can these bones be revived? His vision of the valley, I'm talking about Ezekiel, his vision of the valley of dry bones and life being breathed into these bones. Spiritually, outside of the will and the word of God. Ezekiel's ministry begins in Babylon, with condemnation and judgment in the nation of Judah. Condemnation and judgment. Now, again, we have to understand that there are consequences to our choices. God will deal with sin. He's going to deal with sin, whether you believe it or not. It's going to happen. You know, and we don't know when it's going to happen, but we know that it is going to happen. But after the destruction of Jerusalem, Ezekiel's perspective changes. The destruction of Jerusalem happened, and so he looked at it, and my thought process now, because I've seen, because I witnessed, because I've experienced the destruction, my mindset changes. What will it take for us to change our mindsets? Will it take a beating? Will it take a talking to? What will it take for us? But Ezekiel, he looked and he saw a glimmer of hope. He saw a glimmer of hope for the future. Ezekiel's purpose was to announce God's judgment. God went to the prophet. The prophet went to the people. Hey, Moses, go tell Pharaoh to let my people go. God went to Moses. Moses went to Pharaoh, and we know the rest of that story. But Ezekiel was to tell of God's judgment. Have you ever had anyone speak prophetically to you? Where did that come from? What did you say? What? Where did you get that from? But it is very powerful. A few years back, but I had that experience, and it was very, very powerful. People, we have to be careful how we entertain strangers. That's what the Word of God says. You don't know where that message is going. Now, we can identify. We test the Spirit by the Spirit. But people will come to you at some point, maybe, and speak prophetically to you. Just keep that in mind. We don't know. And so Ezekiel, the other nations, and he foretold the eventual salvation to God's people. We know that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. God wants none of us to perish, but to have everlasting life. And how do we have that everlasting life? We become obedient to his word and to his will. Be obedient. Obedience. I'll say it again, to be obedient. Children, be obedient. Be obedient to your parents. Your parents are not going to tell you anything that's going to harm you, even with your grandparents. You may not like it at the time, but by and by, you will see. You will see, and you will come to appreciate that. When we understand, when we know what the Master's will is, if we are obedient to that, then we'll be okay. The servant who knows what his master wants, but does not do what the master wants, will be beaten with what? Many blows. The servant who knows what the master wants, we know that God is our master, but does not do what the master wants, will be beaten. Now, the individual, the servant that may not know, is still going to get beat, but it won't be with as many blows. There's a beating that's going to take place. Yeah. We have to identify and then again be obedient what the will of our master is. How do we do that? Well, we continue to read. We continue to study. One of the things that I find interesting is, you know, having that mentor, having a mentor that can share with you, that can speak to you, that you can call on and call up and they can advise you. Having that mentor that you can reach out to without judgment, without anything other than identifying with these, with the Word of God. Can these bones live again? And I'm so glad that we don't have that issue in this church. That we have a spirit in this church. I'm so glad that there are no dry bones, that we don't have to deal with that. Jesus, this renewing of our minds, this mindset, this new life of this nation, this renewing of our minds, this being born again. We have to renew our thinking. We have to be born again so that we can enter into the gates. Jesus said that I will take you out of the nations. I will gather you from all the countries and bring you back into your own land. I will sprinkle you clean with water. Can these bones live again? On you shall be clean. I will cleanse you from all impurities and from all your idols. I will give you a new heart and a new spirit in you. I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. Can these bones live again? He will. He will. He will. It didn't say Jack will, Joe will. God will. These bones can live again. I will. The hand of the Lord was upon me. Verse 1 in chapter 37. The hand of the Lord was upon me. The hand of the Lord is upon us, is upon you. It's touched you to go out and to do his will. His will. The hand of the Lord is upon all of us. But now, it's a choice. Ezekiel chose to be obedient to God. Ezekiel could have turned his back. I'm not going to do that. But Ezekiel chose to be obedient to God. Are we being obedient, self-examination, to the will of God? The hand of who? Ezekiel said the hand of the Lord. Yes. Verse 1. You didn't close your book yet. You didn't close your Bible yet, did you? All right. The hand of the Lord was upon me. Yes. To serve his people. The disciples asked the question, who is the greatest God? Who is the greatest Lord? Who is the greatest? And that answer to that question, you well know, is that if you consider yourself great, then you must become a servant. You have to serve. We have to serve. And so these are things that we in this self-examination. He said that he brought me out by the Spirit. We know that God is the Spirit. How did he bring Ezekiel out? By the Spirit. We know that God is the Spirit, and we must worship him in truth and in spirit. Verse 2, he led me. He led me. He led me. Joe didn't leave me. Jack didn't leave me. Sarah didn't leave me. He led me back and forth, back and forth. Guess what? If God is leading us, you're in pretty good hands. Is God leading you? Is God leading us? Is God leading me? You know, so if he leads us, we know that we are being led by our Lord and Savior. He will not lead us in an unrighteous way. But we have to, again, be obedient to him. Can these bones live again? What say ye, Ezekiel? He asked the question, Ezekiel, can these bones live again? That's kind of like a question that, was he trying to set Ezekiel up? We know that our Lord and Savior knows. He already knows that. He can put breath, he can put life back into these bones. But what did Ezekiel do? How did Ezekiel respond? He said, Lord, Lord, thou knowest. Not me, but thou knowest. He didn't say, yeah, I think so. No. Lord, thou knowest. There was a level of submission there. There was a level of acknowledgement there that our Lord and Savior, he knows. These dry bones represented the people's spiritually dead condition. And like I said, I'm so glad here at Forest Heights, we don't have that issue. You know, there may be some churches you attend that may not be as lively or may not have that spirit. But God can restore the vitality. He can raise the spirituality, the vitality. But just as God promised to restore his nation, the nation, he can restore any household of faith, no matter what, no matter how dry it may be. The hope and prayer of every church should be for a restoration, for God to restore it to life. God is at work calling his people back to himself, bringing new life into churches. Can these bones live again? In closing, I would just like to say, no matter what condition we are in, you are in, I am in, he's able to give hope to the hopeless. He's able to give sound to the deaf. He was able to raise Lazarus from the dead. He's able to let the oppressed go free. He is able. He is able to give us a new heart, put a new spirit in us. He's able to heal the sick, able to mend the brokenhearted. Know that God is able. He is an able God. I thank you all for allowing me to share with you on this Sunday, this beautiful Sunday, I'm going to say outside. If you want God, if you want that relationship, if you want him to lead you, if you want him to guide you, if you want him to create a new spirit within you, this is the opportunity to come into the church. The doors of the church are open. The doors of the church are open. If you don't have that relationship with him, we encourage you to be a part of this ministry, this church, but if not here, please, any Bible-believing, preaching, teaching church, we just want you to have eternal life. And as we said, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God. The doors of the church are open. An opportunity to speak with our Lord and Savior.
I come just as I am and waiting not to rid my soul of one dark blood.
An opportunity
to thee,
speak with our Lord and Savior.
Whose blood can cleanse each spot, O Lamb of God.
Glory, glory, glory.
I come.
Praise you, God.
Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fighting with fears without, O Lamb of God,
yeah.
I come.
Yeah. Glory.
I come.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Just
glory.
As I am poor. Side riches, healing of the mind. All I need in thee,
glory,
to find, O Lamb of God. Just as I am, thou wilt receive, wilt welcome, pardon, cleanse, relief, because thy promise. I believe. I am thy love unknown hath broken every barrier down. Now to be thine, hear thine alone, O Lamb of God, I come. I come.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for that which has transpired here today. We ask, Heavenly Father, as we apart from this dwelling, but never from your sight, that you continue to strengthen us, to encourage us, to keep us in your unchanging hands. Now by thee, O God, who have made us in the Holy Spirit that comforts us, do I pray and say, amen. 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 Amen.